Welcome back to ajspeller.com. In today's video, we're going to solve a tangent line problem. And we're going to do that using implicit differentiation. All right, so what we need to do is we need to find the equation of the tangent line to the curve below. This here is the curve at the point 1, 0. And we're going to do that by first taking the derivative of each one of these terms. So let's begin. The derivative of x to the second power is actually just 2x. And now we have to take the derivative of sine of y. So first we're going to use the chain rule here. So we're going to take the derivative of the outside, which is sine. The derivative of sine is cosine. So we write in our cosine and we keep y in the parentheses. And now by the chain rule, I need to take the derivative of the y. Well, derivative of y is just 1. But because we're using implicit differentiation, I'm taking the derivative of y with respect to x. So I need to tack on here a factor of y prime. Now I move on to my next term. In my next term, I'm going to have to use a combination of the product rule and the power rule. I begin by writing my first factor, which is x, and then taking the derivative of the second factor. It's y squared. Its derivative is 2y. I just took the derivative of y with respect to x, so I need to tack on a factor of y prime. And again, continuing with the product rule, I need to add. And this time, I'm going to take the derivative of x, which is just 1. And then I'm going to write the second factor, which is y squared. And then when I take the derivative of a constant, that's just plus 0. And I really don't need to write it, so I'm going to take that off. Now what I need to do is I need to collect my y primes, or my y primes together, and move the other terms so that they're together. So let's do that by, I'm going to subtract this term to put it over here to the left. Matter of fact, I'm going to do it in stages. So I've got 2x plus cosine y. Well, I'm multiplying by 1, so I don't need to write the 1, so I'm just going to write y prime. And then I'm going to subtract this term from the right-hand side to put it to the left-hand side. So this is going to be negative x 2y y prime equal to 1 times y squared, which is just y squared. Now I want to get this 2x out of the way. I want to move this 2x to the other side. So I'm going to subtract that from both sides. So here I have cosine of y prime minus x 2y y prime is equal to negative 2x, because I'm subtracting it, negative 2x plus y squared. Now I did all that so that I can now factor out the y prime from this term and from this term. So I put my y prime out front, and I'm left with cosine y minus x 2y, and that's set equal to negative 2x plus y squared. Now I can divide both sides by this entire factor here, which is cosine y minus x2y. Do the same thing here. Cosine y minus x2y. These two factors cancel, and I'm left with y prime is equal to negative 2x plus y squared, all that divided by cosine y minus x 2y. Now that I have everything on one side and I have the y prime on the other side, I'm able to substitute in the point 1, 0 where my x values are 1 and my y values are 0. And I'm going to do that here in this next step. So here I've got negative 2 times x, well, x is a 1, plus y squared. Y is a 0 squared. I'm going to divide that by the cosine of y, well, y is 0, minus x, which is a 1, times 2, times y, which is a 0. And now I'm going to simplify. I've got negative 2 times 1, which gives me negative 2, plus 0 squared is just 0. Then I'm going to divide that by, well, the cosine of 0 is 1, and Again, if you don't know that, that's something you can look at some other tutorials I have talking about the unit circle and other trig information. And then I'm going to subtract that from 1 times 2 times 0. Well, anything times 0 is 0, so I'm left with a 0 here. And this simplifies down to a negative 2 over 1, which just turns out to be a negative 2. So we found the slope of that tangent line to be negative 2. Let me scroll down some, and we'll continue working. We'll continue working here. And right, we said the point was at 1, 0. So let's rewrite. Let's rewrite part of that. So we know the point's at 1, 0. So we have a x value, we have a y value, and we just found m to be negative 2. So we're going to use this slope-intercept form, where that form is y is equal to mx plus b. We know that y is 0. We know that m is the negative 2. We know that x is that 1. And then we're going to put all that together to figure out what b is. So here I have 0 is equal to negative 2 times 1 to give me negative 2 plus b. I end up adding 2 to both sides. So here I see that 2 is equal to b. So I can rewrite the equation for the tangent line as y is equal to m, which is negative 2, x plus the value of b, which we said was 2. So this here is the equation of the tangent line to that curve at the point 1, 0. And now let's take a look at what this, let's take a look at this graphically. All right, so let's come over, let's put the equation in, which is, let's put this equation in, which is x to the second plus sine y is equal to x y to the second plus 1. All right, next let's put in the point that we're working with, which was 1, 0. And then let's just pull over, and we see that there is the point. And now let's put in the equation for the tangent line, which is y is equal to negative 2x plus 2. And then here we see the tangent line going through the curve at the point 1, 0. All right, that sums up this video by ajspeller.com. If you have any questions or comments, please let us know. And as always, thank you for watching.